Tuesday morning in Manchester, and the cold made it tough to tell who was walking by, as people were all bundled up on their way to school or work. Abigail Pandolina giving a demonstration of how she was dealing with it.
Like this. It's brutal, absolutely brutal. But I did just say it's better today than it was yesterday.
When asked how she was dealing with the cold.
Not well. It's very cold.
Yeah. And what have you been doing the last couple of days?
Sitting on my couch, enjoying some hot chocolate.
I've been trying to limit my exposure to it as much as possible.
You're still laughing, though.
You have to, really. I mean, it's kind of ridiculous otherwise.
Speaking of which, there are the conditions atop Mount Washington.
Currently, we're sitting at an air temperature of -9. Winds are still sustained over 100, or sitting at about 101 to 102 miles an hour.
That translates into wind chill temperatures of 55 below zero. In cold like that, the scientists have to limit their time outside to 5 minutes an hour and make sure every part of their skin is covered.
You can start getting frostbite about 2 minutes, and after about 3 or 4 minutes, you start getting permanent damage.
While the cold can be brutal, -27 last night, that's not the toughest thing to deal with.
Even when you wear windproof clothing and are completely geared up, the wind can still get to the seams of your clothes or maybe like underneath your shirt or something, and it gets cold really fast.
Even for buildings designed to handle weather like this or worse, problems still arise that homeowners can relate to.
Where the pipes are freezing on the outside, so we're trying to keep up with putting on heat tape and whatnot.
As you take a live look at the winds here in Manchester, Gill says they're also having problems keeping the heat up inside their building. It's around 60 degrees right now. Again, he says he's not looking forward to the warm-up headed our way. I still think he's in the minority. Reporting live in Manchester, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.